This is Coding Math, episode 21, Bitmap Collision Detection. A while back, we covered various forms of collision detection, and I believe I made a promise to cover collision detection with bitmaps at some point in the future. Well, the future is now. First of all, what exactly is a bitmap? At its most basic, it's a rectangular grid of values that are used to set the colors of pixels in a rectangular portion on the screen. 0.00 in that grid would be the top left pixel, and the point represented by bitmap width minus 1, bitmap height minus 1, would be the bottom right pixel. Every pixel in the bitmap is addressable by an XY coordinate, and in many systems you can get the pixel value at that location with a function usually called something like getPixelXY, and set its value with a function like setPixelXYColor. Generally, the pixel value can be broken down into red, green, blue, and alpha channels. If only Canvas were so simple. But we'll get to that complaint shortly. The simplest strategy in bitmap collision detection is to take an empty, transparent bitmap and then draw a shape in it. Now, all the pixels in that bitmap will have an alpha channel value of 0, except those where the shape is drawn. Now, say you have a particle moving along here. It's currently at some position xy, and you want to know if it's hit this object you've drawn. Well, you can get the pixel value at that xy point, and if the alpha value there is greater than 0, your particle has collided with that shape. Now, of course, that's only really useful for point-to-shape collisions, but it's something to get started with anyway. Now, the problem in HTML5 is that Canvas doesn't have a simple getPixel or setPixel function. What you have to do is call getImageData on the context. This returns an ImageData object. The ImageData object has three properties: width, height, and data. Width and height are pretty obvious, and data is a special type of array containing the pixel values. As an important note, you should know that the ImageData you get from a context is fixed. If you draw something else to the canvas after getting that ImageData, or you clear the canvas, or in any other way change that bitmap, then the image data you have is no longer a current representation of what you see in the canvas. You'll have to call getImageData again to get the updated pixel data from that bitmap. Now, you might guess that this data property that holds the pixel values is a two-dimensional array, and you might expect that you could say something like imageData.dataIndexX_indexY to get the pixel value at location XY. But that would be wishful thinking. The data property is actually a one-dimensional array, and it goes something like this. Element 0 is the red value of pixel 00. Element 1 is the green value of pixel 00. Element 2 is the blue value of that pixel. And element 3 is the alpha value. These are all in a range of 0 to 255. Then, element 4 is the red value of the next pixel, located at x equals 1, y equals 0, and so on. So you have a one-dimensional array with four elements for every pixel. Therefore, if you want to know the color value at any particular xy position, you've got some math to do. Now, if each pixel took up one element in that array, you'd find the index of a particular xy pixel by saying index equals image data width times y plus x. So, for example, if your bitmap is 100 pixels wide, and x was 10 and y was 5, you'd have 100 times 5, which is 500, plus x, which is 10, so you'd be at index 510 in that one-dimensional array. But since each pixel takes up 4 elements, you have to multiply all that by 4. So index equals image data width times y plus x, all of that times 4. So in the above example, you'd be at index 2040. That index would point to the red value of the pixel at 10, 5. You can then get the other channel values using offsets to that index. So red would be imageData.dataIndex. Green would be imageData.dataIndex plus 1. Blue would be at index plus 2. And the alpha channel would be index plus 3. Now, we could make a getPixel function that encapsulated all that, but let's hold off for just a moment. First, let's take a closer look at the syntax for getting image data from context. It turns out that you don't have to get all of the image data for the entire canvas. When you call getImageData, you pass in the x, y, width, and height coordinates of a rectangle that you'd like to get the image data for. If you passed in 0, 0, canvas width, canvas height, yes, you'd get all of the image data for the whole context. But you can get a sub-rectangle of that canvas as well. Now, it turns out that getting and setting image data from a canvas's context is pretty expensive in terms of processing time. And the more data you get or set, the longer it takes. So you should really only get what you need, and only when you need it. So we could go ahead and get the image data for a single pixel by saying image data equals context get image data x, y, 1, 1. That defines a 1-pixel rectangle at the specified x, y. Then our red, green, blue, and alpha channels for that pixel would be an imageData.data at indexes 0, 1, 2, and 3. That's certainly a lot simpler and only involves getting the data for a single pixel rather than all the pixels. But remember the other part of what I just said, that you should only get the image data when you need it. Using this method, you'd have to call getImageData every time you wanted to check a pixel. If you know that the bitmap is not going to change, it might be more efficient to get the image data for the whole thing one time right up front, and keep it around and do your hit testing on that. But if there's any chance that the bitmap could change, then you'll need to call getImageData each time anyway, to make sure you had the latest data. So in that case, you'd be better off just getting the single pixel each time. These are just things to consider when you use this. I'm not telling you which one you should use, it really depends on your use case. For the example we're going to do next, I'm going to go with the single pixel method. Anyway, that's enough theory. Let's get coding and see how you can use all this to do collision detection. I'm going to start with the usual template, but I'm going to go into the HTML and add a second canvas called target. I'm also going to add a few styles to the canvas CSS. I'll set it to have a position absolute and top and left both 0 pixels. This will put both canvases in the same position, one completely overlaying the other. I'm also going to add a background image to the page just to make it a little bit more dramatic. Now in the main.js file, I'll get that target canvas and its context, storing those in variables target canvas and target context. And then I'll make sure that target canvas is the same size as the original canvas. Then I'll make a particle, set it on the left edge of the screen, and give it a velocity of 10 pixels per frame at an angle of 0. Next, I'm going to draw a large circle in the center of the screen. Note that I'm drawing this on the target context. If we run this now, this is what we'll see. So we've got a picture of the Earth with a big black circle in front of it. This circle is the bitmap that we'll be doing our hit testing on. The other canvas we'll use for displaying the particle. This lets us isolate the bitmap that we'll be doing the hit testing on, so we don't have to worry about the pixels that are used to draw the particle itself, and anything else we might want to draw, like an explosion, other objects, effects, user interface, etc. We'll only be hit testing against that circle. To get things moving, I'll call an update function. And then I'll create that function. The first thing that this is going to do is clear the main canvas. Then it will update the particle and draw the particle on the main canvas. It's then going to call getImageData on the target context, but using the particles x and y. It's just going to get that single pixel. Then we're going to check if imageData.data index 3 is greater than 0. Again, index 3 here will be the alpha channel of that pixel. If it's completely transparent, as most of the pixels will be, that will be 0. If it's not transparent, it will be something greater than 0. So if we get into this if statement, we know that the particle has hit that circle. Now, what I'm going to do next here is a pretty neat trick. I want to make it look like the particle has blown a hole out of that large circle. To do that, I'll draw a 20 pixel radius circle at that point on the target context. But first, I'm going to set global composition operation to destination out. Global composition operation affects how new drawing operations interact with existing content in the canvas. The default that you're used to is to draw the new shape right on top of whatever's there. But there are many more options. I suggest you do a search on that one because there are some pretty useful and generally not so well-known things in there. The destination out operation results in the shape that you're drawing being chopped out of any existing content, like a cookie cutter. It basically acts like an eraser, clearing all the pixels in the shape you drew rather than setting them with a particular color. Now we're drawing an arc, so the result is a hole in that target circle right where we found a collision. If we do get a collision, I'll call reset particle. This will put the particle back on the left edge and give it a somewhat randomized heading. And if the particle goes off the right edge of the screen, I'll reset it as well. Other than that, all that's left to do is call request animation frame, passing in update, so it continues to be called. Finally, I just have to make that reset particle function. Let's see what happens. Well, we have our circle in the center, and the particle shoots out from the left and hits it, leaving a big gaping hole. Next particle comes out, does the same thing. Notice that as time goes on, big chunks are getting torn out of the circle. Now, if we were just going to deal with an unbroken circle, we could use the circle point collision function we created a few weeks back. But here, before long, we're going to have a very irregular shape that it would be extremely difficult to do collision detection on in any way other than using the image data. Of course, different systems and languages will have different capabilities. Flash, for example, has a really amazing bitmap hit test system. You can even test two irregular shapes in separate bitmaps against each other. If any non-transparent pixel from one touches any non-transparent pixel in the other, you've got a hit. Canvas has some cool features coming soon that will help with more complex hit testing. In fact, I read that some of them have even been released in some version of Chrome in this past week. But it's going to be a while before they're widely available in all browsers and platforms. In the meantime, I'm sure you can make lots of use out of this little technique, and I will see you next week.